What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, Marc Anthony Storm. So glad to see your happy faces. And today is Remove Scully Cummins Day. I'm sitting here in Georgia waiting to go down to Florida, but I'm doing my 34-hour reset so I can get my 70-hour clock and be ready to roll once I deliver in Miami. But felt it was best to go ahead and work on the truck, you know, in this gloomy weather, make the day a productive day. So what better thing to do than to remove Scully from where he is and make some changes. So I have to take off Scully from the top of the shifter to access some of the chrome down below. I noticed that the shifter was a little bit loose. I have a 6-inch extension that's there, which is not holding properly. So what I'm gonna do is put some, let's see, I have it somewhere here, and wherever the hell I put it. Well, I have no idea what the hell I did with this piece. All right, so I got it, which is thread locker. I guess it's gonna, you know, it should do the trick, but I had to get this because the 6-inch extension that's on my shifter is just not holding, and Scully is like moving from side to side, and I just for me, I can't drive the truck with this thing, you know, moving back and forth. So I'm gonna go ahead and take it apart. I'm also gonna change one other thing. Hold on. Boy, that took forever. Sorry for the holdup. So I want to put this on instead. And this piece right here is going to replace the piece that's currently sitting there. So I'm not really happy about that. So I don't really like that piece too much, the way it sits with the pipe that goes around the stick shift. We're going to go ahead and make that change. As I said, right now it's like raining outside, not really the best weather. I've been waiting to do this for the past few days and record it and put it up on YouTube so you guys can see. We'll go ahead and get the camera in position so that you guys can follow the step-by-step of how to take this off. And for you guys that are a little bit new to working on your own truck, you'll see how everything is removed from the shifter. And there's a couple things you just have to be careful of, which is the two springs and the one ball bearing. Don't want to lose those parts, because if you lose them, then you're not going to be driving your truck. So let's go ahead and get started with removing this and put it back together while we still have some daylight. finally got Scully Cummins back installed on the truck. He's looking great. He's a happy camper and ready to go. So tomorrow's a new day. We're going to get the truck rolling, heading down to Miami. If you're crossing my path and you want to say hello, please give a shout out and maybe we can shoot your truck on my way down to Miami. You know, I'm super excited to have Scully Cummins back installed and looking better than ever. He's got that smile on his face as always, and the new chrome piece also looks just as good, so I'm happy with the outcome. Was not a problem. Don't forget, there's a ball bearing that's in there along with some springs that may fall out. You don't want that to happen. Pay real close attention when you take off your shifter and you're putting on something. If you're putting on something like Scully Cummins, make sure you pay attention to where the ball bearing is and those springs. So anyway, thank you guys for coming back to the channel, watching Marc Anthony Storm. And if you haven't already, press the subscribe button so that you can be notified of any future videos that I'm putting out. And I will see you guys in the next video.